Welcome back. We are on the topic graph of quadratic functions. In the previous video, we learned how to draw the graph of a quadratic function on a graph sheet. Before we solve a question on drawing the graph of a quadratic function on a graph sheet, we will first have to learn how to use a graph sheet. So in this video, we are going to learn how to use a graph sheet. The graph sheet that we use in our studies and in examinations looks like this. On our graph sheet, we have two main types of lines. We have the thick lines and the thin lines. I'm going to zoom into one portion of our graph sheet so that you see what I'm referring to clearly. So I'll zoom into, let's say, this portion. You can see that we have the thick green lines and we have the thin green lines between them. That's what I'm referring to. So on our graph sheet, we have the thick lines and the thin lines. The thick lines are called major grid lines. So all the thick lines that you see here are known as major grid lines. And the thin lines between them are known as minor grid lines. So the thick lines here are called major grid lines, and the thin lines are called minor grid lines. We can see that some of the thick lines are horizontal, others are vertical. In the same way, some of the thin lines are horizontal, others are vertical. The horizontal thick lines are called horizontal major grid lines, and the vertical thick lines are called vertical major grid lines. In the same way, the horizontal thin lines are called horizontal minor grid lines, and the vertical thin lines are called vertical minor grid lines. So now we know about vertical and horizontal major grid lines and vertical and horizontal minor grid lines. Let's learn more about our graph sheet. On our graph sheet, the distance between one major grid line and the next major grid line is 2 centimeters. So once again, I'll zoom into one portion so that you see what I'm referring to here. The distance between this vertical major grid line and this vertical major grid line is 2 centimeters. In the same way, the distance between this horizontal major grid line and this horizontal major grid line is 2 centimeters. So on our graph sheet, the distance between a major grid line and the next major grid line is 2 centimeters. Another thing about our graph sheet is that from one major grid line to another major grid line, we have 10 divisions between them. Once again, I will zoom in to another portion of our graph sheet so that you see what I'm referring to. What I said was that from one major grid line to another major grid line, we have 10 divisions between them. When I say division, I'm referring to the boxes between the major grid lines. From one vertical major grid line to another vertical major grid line, we have 10 divisions between them. In the same way, from one horizontal major grid line to another horizontal major grid line, we have 10 divisions between them. These are very, very important. You have to know them because you are going to use them as the video continues. So we have learned that on this graph sheet, we have vertical and horizontal major grid lines. We have vertical and horizontal minor grid lines. We have also learned that the distance between one major grid line and the next major grid line is 2 centimeters. And between two major grid lines, we have 10 divisions. Okay, let's learn more about our graph sheet. Before we start plotting points on our graph sheet, we will have to choose one of the horizontal major grid lines as our main horizontal major grid line, or our principal horizontal major grid line. This main or principal horizontal major grade line is called the x-axis. So before we start plotting our points, we will have to choose one of these horizontal major grade lines as our x-axis. So let's say that we choose this horizontal major grade line as our x-axis. We will have to do the same thing for the vertical major grade lines. We will have to choose one of them as the main vertical major grade line or the principal vertical major grade line. This main or principal vertical major grade line is called the y-axis. So we will choose one of these vertical major grade lines as our y-axis. Let's say that we choose this one. After drawing the x and y axis, they are going to intersect at a point. Their point of intersection is known as the origin. It is numbered 0. All the points on our graph sheet will be in reference to the origin. So all the numbering that you have on this graph sheet will be in reference to this origin. Looking at our graph sheet, we can see that the x-axis has been divided into two parts. We have the right-hand side part and the left-hand side part. In the same way, the y-axis has also been divided into two parts. We have the upward part and the downward part. So with the origin at the center, we have the left-hand side on the x-axis, we have the right-hand side on the x-axis, and we have the upward part on the y-axis and the downward part on the y-axis. When we are numbering the x-axis, the positive numbers are on the right-hand side. So we have the positive numbers on the right-hand side and the negative numbers are on the left-hand side. When we are numbering the y-axis, the positive numbers are on the upward part and the negative numbers are on the downward part. So, after the x-axis has been divided into two, the negative numbers will be on the left-hand side and the positive numbers will be on the right-hand side. And after the y-axis has been divided into two, the positive numbers will be on the upward part and the negative numbers will be on the downward part. Now, let's learn how to number the x-axis and the y-axis. Before we number the x-axis and the y-axis, you will have to know the scale of the graph. In some questions, you will be asked to choose your own scale to draw the graph. But in other questions, the scale of the graph will be given to you. Let's say that the scale of the graph that we are going to draw is 2 cm to 1 unit on both axes. This means that we are going to use a scale of 2 cm to 1 unit on the x-axis, and we will use a scale of 2 cm to 1 unit on the y-axis. So how do we use this scale to number our x-axis and the y-axis? Let's begin with the x-axis. Remember that the scale on the x-axis is 2 cm to 1 unit. We have learned that on our graph sheet, the distance between one major grade line and the next major grade line is 2 cm. So if we take this major grade line, which we are calling the y-axis, the distance between the y-axis and this major grade line is 2 cm. The distance between this major grade line and the next major grade line is 2 cm, and it continues for all the other major grade lines. The scale we are using on the x-axis is 2 cm to 1 unit. That means that after every 2 cm, you have to increase the previous number by 1. So after every 2 cm, you increase the previous number by 1. As I've already said, all our numbering will be in reference to the origin. So you will start from the origin. From the origin, the next 2 cm will be on this major grade line. So to get the number on this major grade line, you have to increase the previous number by 1. The previous number here is 0. So if we increase 0 by 1, you have 0 plus 1, which is 1. Remember that on the x-axis, the positive numbers are on the right-hand side. So the numbers here will be positive. To get the next number, you have to move 2 cm. from this major grade line, the next 2 centimeters will be on the next major grade line, which is this one. So to get the number here, we will increase what we have here by 1, because we are using a scale of 2 centimeters to 1 unit. So if we increase 1 by 1, you have 1 plus 1, which is 2. To get the next one, you increase it by 1, which will give us 3. To get the next one, you increase it by 1, which will give us 4. And the next one will be 5. The numbering on the positive side and the negative side are done in a similar manner. The only difference is that on the negative side, the numbers will be negative. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on the positive side. On the negative side, you have negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, and negative 5. So we have now numbered our x-axis. Let's go to the y-axis. We are using a scale of 2 centimeters to 1 unit on both axes. So it means that on the y-axis also, the scale is 2 centimeters to 1 unit. So in the same way, from this major grade line, which we are calling the x-axis, to the next major grade line is 2 centimeters. So from here to here is 2 centimeters. So to get the number here, you have to increase the number here by 1. The number here is 0. So if you increase it by 1, you have 1, because 0 plus 1 is 1. On the y-axis, the numbers on the upward part are positive and the numbers on the downward part are negative. So we have 1 here, the next one will be 2, the next one is 3, the next one is 4, the next one is 5, and the next one is 6. In the same way, on the negative part, you have negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, and negative 6. So we have now numbered both our x-axis and the y-axis. Let's choose a different scale for our graph sheet and number it again so that you'll be conversant with numbering the x and y-axis. So this is another graph sheet. We have learned that before we plot the points, we have to choose one of the horizontal lines as our x-axis and we choose one of the vertical lines as our y-axis. So let's say that we choose this horizontal line as our x-axis and we choose this vertical line as our y-axis. When we do that, they will intersect at this point. So this point here becomes our origin. All our numbering will be in reference to this origin. Let's say that the scale we are using for this graph sheet is 2 centimeters to 2 units on the x-axis and 2 centimeters to 5 units on the y-axis. So on the x-axis, we are using a scale of 2 centimeters to 2 units, and on the y-axis, we are using a scale of 2 centimeters to 5 units. On the x-axis, the positive numbers will be on the right-hand side, and the negative numbers will be on the left-hand side. On the y-axis, the positive numbers will be on the upward part, and the negative numbers will be on the downward part. So let's begin by numbering the x-axis. The scale on the x-axis is 2 centimeters to 2 units. So this is the origin. The next major grade line, which will give us 2 centimeters, is this. And the scale is 2 centimeters to 2 units. So from 0, the next one will be 2. The next one, we will increase 2 by 2, we will get 4. The next one, we increase 4 by 2, we will get 6. We increase 6 by 2, you get 8. We increase 8 by 2, you get 10. We increase 10 by 2, you get 12. And the next one, you increase 12 by 2, you get 14. The numbering is done in a similar way for the negative side. The only difference is that the numbers there will be negative. So you have negative 2, negative 4, and negative 6. On the y-axis, the scale is 2 centimeters to 5 units. From our origin, this is the next major grade line. The scale is 2 centimeters is to 5 units. So from 0, the next number will be 5. The next one will be 10. The next one will be 15. The next one will be 20. So you see that you keep on increasing it by 5 because the scale is 2 centimeters to 5 units. The next one will be 25. The next one will be 30. You have 35 and 40. And for the negative side, you have negative 5, negative 10, negative 15, and negative 20. You can see that the position of the x and y axis on this graph sheet is different from the position of the x and y axis on the previous graph sheet. So one may ask, how will I know where to draw my x and y axis? It's not difficult at all. As the video continues, we are going to learn how to position our x and y axis. Time is up for this video. Subscribe to this channel for more videos. In this video, we have learned how to use the scale of the graph to number the x and y axis on a graph sheet. In the next video, we are going to learn how to plot points on a graph sheet. Bye-bye.